everyone, welcome to my channel Valtech. So today we are going to be performing a lab on port ACL, which is short for PACL. So to those of you who this term is actually new to them, so PACL is also a type of access control list, but we actually configured this type of ACL on layer 2 switches. So the other types of ACL are often performed on, so those performed on routers and multi-layer switches are what we call the RACLs, that is router access control list. But then with respect to this particular one, which is the PACL, we configure these on layer 2 switches. So as you might have guessed, this type of ACL filters traffic based on MAC addresses. Since it is configured on layer 2 switches, it only filters traffic based on MAC addresses, unlike its other types which filters traffic based on IP addresses. Right, so let's get on with it. So we have in our topology two switches here interconnecting these two pieces, PC1 and PC2. Now PC1 and PC2 here on the same network, is that okay? But we don't want PC1 to be able to communicate with devices on this side of the topology, okay? So we are assuming there are other devices on this side as well, aside PC2, there might be PC3, PC4 and all that here. So we don't want PC1 here specifically to not communicate any device on this side of the network. Is that okay? So we need to, so we can do this by performing, by configuring PACL on switch 2 here in order to prevent this device from communicating with devices on this side. Right, so let's get on with it. So let's configure IP addresses. So let's first check if there's an IP. Okay, there's no IP. So 10.1.1.10 slash 24. And PC2 is 10.1.1.20 slash 24. Right. Okay, show IP. Right. Okay, right. So let's see, let's check our MAC address table to see if there have been any entries. Show MAC address table. Okay, so we've already had some entries in here. Right, so now let's take note. Switch 1 here, PC1 MAC address can be found on, so PC1 can be found on gigabit 01 here. So this is the MAC address of PC1. Let's copy that. Alright. So this is the MAC address for PC1. Show MAC address table. For PC2 is on gigabit 01 as well. So there's a MAC address for PC2. Right. Okay, that's fine. So now the first thing that we need to do, let's access our global configuration mode. So in order to configure port ACL, we need to use the command MAC access list. This is the first command that you issue. Okay. So now MAC, so we then need to use the extended access list. So the next thing for us to do is to give it a name. Okay, so a name for the extended access list that we'll be creating. So let's, since we'll be blocking PC1, let's intentionally use this. So block PC1 is just a name. Okay, you can use any name at all there to identify this access list. Right, we hit enter. So here we have a couple of commands in here, but what we'll be focusing on is towards deny PC1 to communicate with any device on this side of the network. we'll use the command deny. So the next thing is to then specify the source MAC address, and the source MAC address is here, which is PC1. So we just copy that, copy, paste it right here. Okay, before we do that, since we want to deny a single host, it's best to use the host command here first, host, before entering the MAC address of the host device for PC1. Paste it here. Okay, seems. Let me recopy that. Okay. Copy. Paste. Okay. So the next thing is to, since you want to prevent it from communicating with any device at all here, not just PC2 alone, we use the command any. So any what destination MAC address. So we just type in any here. Is that okay? And we hit the enter. Now, once we are done, because of the implicit deny rule for at the end of every access list, this basically means that if we are to connect maybe another PC here on this side, that PC also wouldn't be able to communicate with devices on this side of the network. So to prevent that, to override the implicit deny rule, we need to issue a command whereby we permit any host, any source host device to communicate with any what destination host device, right? So we are done, but then we are only done configuring or setting up our access control list. So let's check it out. So sorry, do show. Right, so this is our configuration. So we have to, this is our access list. This is our first entry, and our second entry. Is that okay? Now we need to apply it to a particular interface. Now one thing you need to know with regards to port ACL is that you can only apply it inbound on the, that is on the ingress port of the switch that you are configuring it on. So now when we say ingress port, is the port which accepts what incoming connections. And since PC1 here will be communicating with devices here, the traffic will move from here, get to switch one, and then here. So this gigabit 0/0 here becomes our ingress port or our inbound interface, whilst Gabi 01 here becomes our egress port or outbound or outgoing interface. So let's access Gabi 0/0. So interface Gabi 0/0. Then we need to use the command MAC access group. Then we need to enter the name of the ACL that we created. So the name was what? We use block PC1. Okay, so we need to enter the exact name. So block underscore PC1. Then as you can see, we can only apply it inbound on the ingress port, which is GABI 0/0. So we then use in, and we are done. We are done configuring PACL. So now let's test to see if our connections would work. So now we want PC1 to talk to PC2, okay? So PC1 has an IP address of 10.1.1.10. PC2 is .20. So let's ping PC2. Okay, hold on. Let's ping get this. Let me ping myself. Let me make sure my IP stack is working. Okay, so now let me try to ping PC. Before I do that, let me also confirm PC. The IP stack for PC2 works just fine. Okay, so now let me ping PC2. As you can see, we are unable to reach PC2. It says not reachable. That particular traffic has been filtered, or was filtered here by switch 2. So PC1 is unable to communicate with PC2. Is that okay? So now let's remove the entry. Okay, let's try to remove the entry that we did here. So say Mac, okay, so Mac access list extended block PC1. So we issued a command deny, right? So before we do that, let's check. So do show run pipe include access list. Okay, let me use section in order to get that particular line of configuration. Okay, so we use this command deny host this from communicating with any. Okay, so we are going to copy that command. So we are going to remove that command, that specific command that we issued there. Is that okay? But one thing you need to know is that because of this command we issued here, permit any, the moment I remove this command here, which denies PC1 from communicating with any device on this side, PC1 should be able to now communicate to PC2 or any device here at all. Is that okay? So let me remove that command and paste it in there first. Right, so I've removed that command. Now let's test to see if it's no more there. Okay, so it has been removed and we only have the permit any. So now from PC1, let's try to ping PC20 and it works just fine. Let's put the command back in there. We use the node to remove it. Now we are going to bring it back. Do show run access list. Okay, but notice that the permit any has come in first before the deny host this any. So this will be a problem because access control list processes its entries from top to bottom. So since we are permitting any here, it means that even though we've issued a command to deny PC1 from communicating with devices on this side, due to this first command here, PC1 would be able to communicate because there's a match. Is that okay? Let's test that theory. See, PC1 is still able to communicate with PC2. So to fix that issue, we need to make sure that this permit any here comes in what second, or comes in last at the bottom or underneath this particular command. Is that okay? So first let's remove the permit any. So no permit any. Let's see if it's no more. Okay, it's no more. So now we're just going to bring it back. Okay, so permit any. But before I do that, notice that because we remove the permit any, leaving only this particular entry, PC1 would now be unable to communicate with PC2, as you can see. Host is what? Unreachable. By the moment, but even if I bring it back, it still wouldn't be able to communicate because we now have this entry below, and since ACL processes its entries from top to bottom, PC1 will still not be able to communicate with PC2, as you can see there. Right, so that is how we configure what we call port ACL. Is that okay? So I'll be doing another video on VACL, so try to check the playlist. Is that okay? Check my playlist, the access control is playlist, for that video, in order to learn how to configure what we call VACL or VLAN ACL. Thank you very much, and don't forget to subscribe to my channel. If you like the video, to like it, and have a good day.